Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel Exotic Scents with Nikhil, and today we have a very affordable luxury perfume from the house of Abdul Karim Al Faransi. This is Sheikh Al Faransi and it is an attar. Enjoy the review. So welcome back everyone. We are talking about Sheikh Al Faransi attar. This is how it looks, a beautiful presentation, something which the collectors would be proud of. Heavy metal top with a traditional glass dipstick inside, thick honey-like concoction. We have some velvet at the bottom to protect the surface and laser engraved names of the company in Arabic and English. Very traditional, very beautiful, great stuff. Now let's get into the fragrance. This is a very authentic experience. I can say with 100% confidence that this will compete with the best Amouage attars, homage and tribute, which cost about $650 for 30 ml and around $300 for 3 ml. And this one only costs 25 Great British Pounds, which is equal to about $30 and 2000 Indian rupees for a 3 ml or a quarter tola. You can order 6 ml or half tola or a full tola, which is about 12 ml. You can also order samples of 1 ml and lesser than that, which is a great, great thing. Now, this fragrance has a beautiful rose at the top, which is mixed with amber, so it gives it a very exotic, luscious sort of a feel. Very, very authentic. And the top notes are also supported by this spicy tobacco-like effect coming from the saffron. Very high quality note and very well blended. The heart note has mostly ambergris and amber. That musty labdanum has a sweet resinous effect, almost a gooey chocolatey effect, which is very, very comforting. It's superb. You feel like you're wearing oud candy on you, and that ambergris just shines. The incense just shines. Very unique, very beautiful. It feels like you are going back into time into a huge Arabian palace. And the smell of bakhus flying everywhere, some high quality agarwood burning. It's just something of a magical creation. The base and the heart have a huge dose of animalic musk, which has a hint of beautiful sensual leather. It's not at all off-putting or dirty or fecal in any way. And the whole scent feels like a top class, high-end niche fragrance. And the best fragrance that I can actually compare it to from the niche market is Asmar from the house of Sooud, one of the best musk-based fragrances out there. Really respected nose, Stephen Humbert Lucas, and I'm comparing this with this. This is only 25 Great British Pounds, guys. So I'm absolutely stunned by this fragrance. I bought this almost a year back. Now I'm wearing it after six months. And it's still giving me the chills. For the price, I don't think I can get anything better. Now, men and women will both enjoy this. However, this leans more towards masculine because of that saffron, because it gives that spicy tobacco-like effect. But if you don't mind wearing those spicy, heavy amber fragrances, you will not have any hesitancy to wear this fragrance. This is not something which you'll wear every day. This is for special occasions and definitely for mature noses or people who are already initiated into ouds and attars. The oud is soft, it's subtle, it's almost like a honeyed, sweet, caramelic, chocolatey oud, which is basically a representation of Cambodian oud, one of the most balanced ouds in the world. And this will have a great performance, 8 to 10 hours easily on a pleasant day, in hot summers maybe 5 to 6 hours, with a great projection for the first 2 hours, and then it becomes a soft skin scent, but it will still project about one arm's length. So when you're walking, the sillage is going to be superb and very, very appealing. Now, the best thing about attars is it's an intimate affair. It's more of a personal experience rather than trying to appeal others, and that's what works with attars. The quality is absolutely top-notch. You never for a moment feel that you're wearing a cheap attar, or there are no off-putting notes here, no plasticky no overwhelming soapy ingredients which you get from most of the attars made by these Arabic commercial houses like Rasasi, Abdul Samad Al Quraishi. This is like a high quality attar, guys. Don't miss this one. This is a masterpiece from the house of Abdul Karim Al Faransi, and I'm looking forward to testing a lot many and then reviewing it all for you. Arabs, non-Arabs, everyone will be able to appreciate the quality and the beauty of blending that has gone into the making of this perfume. I hope you enjoyed today's review, guys, and we'll be back for more. I'm Nikhil, signing off now. Take care. Bye-bye.